Just got off the bridge, off the bus, and came across the bridge, Verrazano, and now I have about a 19-minute walk to get to Fort Wadsworth. So let's take a hike.
Yes, we're almost there. How can I tell? Well, the Arthur von Briesen Park is right before the fort. We've never explored the park, but the fort is right up ahead. Maybe on the way back. Right now, let's stay on our mission. So I decided to come to the park first after all. Yes, there it is. There's the fort, and we're gonna see more of it when we get over there. Okay, so now let's get a closer shot. I'm going to zoom in. There we are. Wow. Wow, it's too bad there's no way to walk directly over there from here. But we'll take the long way. Okay, that was nice. Now time to get back to business. Going to leave the park, Arthur von Briesen Park, and we're going to head right up to through Fort Wadsworth to get to the actual fort flag, the old-fashioned fort. Here we are. Guard shack is empty. Fort Wadsworth, Gateway National Recreation Area. As you can see there.
We're about to cross underneath the bridge. Yeah, you can see now, here is a big open field. And up ahead is the wall, the walkway. Let's go.
Oh, this is really nice. See those buttercups in the grass as we make our way. Very spring-like here.
Okay, almost there.
First, let's take a look at where we came from. Yeah, see? That's the hill we came down. And that is where we're going.
Wow. You don't get this kind of a view of a bridge like this.
Connecting Bay Ridge, New York to Staten Island and roughly spanning 13,700 feet long and 693 feet above the high water mark stands the Verrazano Bridge. The Verrazano Bridge plays host to the New York Marathon and is part of the world-renowned view of Shore Road, Brooklyn. Construction began on August 13, 1959. The person in charge was Otmar Hermann Ahnmann. He was an engineer who immigrated to the United States in 1904 and who was also associated with having a hand in design and construction of the Throgsneck, Walt Whitman, Bronx Whitestone, George Washington, Triborough, Gothels, Golden Delaware Memorial, and the Golden Gate Bridge. The Verrazano Bridge was named after Giovanni di Verrazano, who was the first explorer to discover New York Harbor in 1524, before Henry Hudson's. In its first full year, the upper deck carried 48,000 cars per day. The bottom deck, due to open in 1975, but the increased traffic forced its opening in June of 1969. It's been 40 years since the Verrazano Bridge was opened, and it received new attention in 1998 when it was repainted, and again after the bombing of September 11th, for fear of a terrorist attack on the bridge, which could cripple New York Harbor. Today, the Verrazano Bridge stands as it did when it opened, carrying an ever-increasing number of motorists to and from Staten Island. There are talks of installing a walkway at a possible cost between $10 to $30 million, but that remains to be seen. Robert Moses stated, "These gigantic suspended rainbow arches of steel and stone are surely evidence of divine inspiration." Whatever improvements or modifications are made in the future, the Verrazano Bridge stands as an example of man's ingenuity. Thank you for being with us on this short trip into the history of the Verrazano Bridge.
You may recall, we were over there where those trees are, and there's a flag over there. Anyway, we could see from there the very edge of this battery, and it looks a little different from that side. It's good to get different perspectives on it. There's even a nice little bench down there if you wanted to chill out from your walk. But I wouldn't do that. This is for two eyes, not for one. So I couldn't really show you what you see through here, but it gives you a really good view. And this, Fort Wadsworth, this entire area, the strategic coastal location as the Narrows, was used as a staging ground for the massive British invasion of Brooklyn. Oh, my. Those dirty dogs. Yes, and we can see far, far away. On your left is New Jersey, on your right, that's Jersey City, on your right is Manhattan, Lower Manhattan. And over there, of course, is Brooklyn, because we are on the Staten Island side. We're walking alongside the bridge, and over here is something very interesting. I believe this is a part these walls are here for a reason. It's almost like a double barrier, you know? Pretty cool. Dry moat. Oh, it's a moat. Dry moat and counter scarp. They built these 30-foot-high granite walls to form this corridor. A scarp, which is that wall over there, now face a counter scarp, which is that wall over there, over here. creating a 30-foot dry moat. I didn't know you had dry moats. When originally built, the counterscarp extended to behind you to protect Fort Tompkins back in size from land attack. Fort Tompkins. So this is Fort Tompkins. Interesting. Okay. So as you see, that's where it is. Let's do a little zoom. It goes on and on and on. Fascinating. Alrighty, let's start heading out. This structure seems to duplicate this one here. I guess it was some kind of a tower defense or something. And on the other side, there are some makeshift stone steps, but nothing here. And then, look at this here. Some kind of guard station. Very fascinating. And you see, in the distance, it leads out to a opening that is gated down there. Well, we'll have to go around the other side. Our goodbye to the bridge, passing through the last of it, and we head our way back the way we came. And now approaches our bus back to Midtown, the SIM 33C, homeward bound. Let's go on the lower level.